is Shoaib again. I'll be containing the rest of the questions and answers. So this was the question actually. String equals, most of the guys knows. Sometimes they'll ask you to compare string buffer. So in string buffer, if you use string buffer and compare, the output will be false and false. Let me just quickly type it for you. String buffer s4 equals to new string buffer of show. So same thing, see here, let's use 5, quick one. So if I try to print this one here, if you see I'm comparing s4 s5, same way I'm just using double equals s4 dot equals s5. Okay, let's slow this now. Okay, let me run this for you. I am commentating because you know I'm getting the error here. So this was the question actually. What will be the output for this? If I compare S1, S2, S3 and you know S4 and S5. So let me quickly run this for you. See, this is true. S1 dot equals, it will compare the S1 dot equals, it will compare content, and S1 dot S2 false. If you see here S1 S2, because this is, it compares the objects internally. S1, S3 will be true because you know it's not creating the object. So it points to the same string pool, that's the reason. S4 and S5, this is false in case of both double equal as well as dot equals. So this in string buffer. In string buffer and even in string builder also you'll find the same thing. If it's instead of string buffer, if you use string builder, S6 and S7, you compare using double equals and dot equals, it will print you false. Okay, we will go to other question. So if you see here, method overriding is finished. So let me take you this one again. So this was a question actually. So they'll give this question and they'll ask what will be the output of this question. See, that's it. So output will be 59. Let me quickly run this for you. Output will be 59. List dot add 059. Here list dot get 0. Setting it as key and you know it's printing the value, exact value. So this is and we'll come here, access modify some. So init blocks demo. See here, this is a very important question. Let me quickly cover this one for you. So this was a question actually, which block will going to execute first and which block will going to execute the last. So I'll explain you in a very simple way. See, I'm creating an object for init blocks demo. So what I have here is I have one static block, another static block. These are initialization block without anything. What will execute first? And this is the constructor with parameter. I'm not calling this. This is a constructor without parameter I'm calling. So what will be the output for this and what it will call first? So the answer is, see, it will call first static block, then second static block in which sequence we wrote. So it calls that. Then it will call first instance init block, then second instance block, then it will call the constructor. So this we must know, it will call first static block, then instance block. This block it will call initialization block, then it will call the constructor. So thank you for watching. This is a part 2 of my video. Going forward I'll be uploading more videos. Thanks a lot. Prepare well for the interviews. Good luck.